And we can compute this using the formula for conditional probability. In this case, what A is the probability that the coin toss is valid. A is valid. And we know that the probability of A is equal to 0.99998. What B is the probability that it's heads. And so the probability of B is the probability of H, which is 0.49999. And now we just have to plug these into the formula. But what we need to use the formula is the probability of A intersect B. And what A is, the probability of A intersect B. Well, what A is valid, the set of heads and tails. What B is heads. So if we intersect heads and tails with heads, well, we get tails. And we know the probability of tails is 0.499999. So that means, using the formula, we have the probability of tails, which is 0.4999, which is the probability of A intersect B. And we're dividing that by the probability of A, which is valid event, which is 0.99998, and we get 0.5. And I should note that this is not the case for real coin tosses. There's no physical coin ever manufactured that has exactly equal chances of landing on both sides. And in fact, with real coin tosses, at least with American currency, there's a much higher percentage, much higher meaning close to 51% rather than 50, that the coin lands on the same side that it started on. When we talk about mathematical coin tosses, we're going to assume that there's no edge case and that it's equally likely that we have a uniform distribution and there are only two outcomes. When we talk about mathematical coin tosses, we're going to assume that we have a uniform distribution and there are only two outcomes.